I feel like you actually know what you're doing.
A little bit.
I'm just flying through life like snowing people.
But only because it's cool and fun.
At some time.
Yes, we should now that we're met. Oh. Action.
Hi, I'm Burke Collins.
And I'm Noelle LaCharite.
And this is 5 ways that you can infuse AI into your applications today. Thing number 1, you can build a bot, which honestly to me sounds a lot like build a bear. So exactly how does this work?
Yeah, so when we now have a artificial intelligence, this machine learning model, that would be really difficult for us to build from scratch, but yeah. It's actually available as a web service, and it's called Q&A Maker. And what it allows you to do is point out to, you know, something that many, many websites already have. It's like an FAQ page, right? You can go to any website's FAQ page, point Q&A Maker, which is qandamaker.ai, point it to that FAQ page, and it'll generate a natural language engine into a bot that will end up giving you about 3 lines of code that you just add to your web application.
And then what do you do with that bot? Like, how do you use it?
Yeah, so it's a conversational application. So at that point, all the questions that were in that FAQ show up as ways for a user using natural language can just type in, like, let's say I was looking at, I don't know, like Azure's FAQ or Xbox's FAQ. Anything in that FAQ, I could now type into a chatbot, and rather than going, which is what I'd have to do, go to the website and look for my question and find the answer, yeah. Now I can just type in the top of my question that I have and poof, I'd get the answer. But the benefit to that is that I don't have to type in exactly the question. I
can type in. You can just get close.
Yeah, I can type in any variation because natural language, the machine learning model behind it, is going to figure it out based on the entities that I have in my question.
Usually when I'm going through an FAQ, it's how do I cancel my subscription?
Right.
To fill in the blank. Any site, like it's reason. So now people can cancel their subscription with
super
a bot.
Easy. Yeah. Yes, yes.
Perfect. The last time we did it, I noticed that I had shaved, but like missed the spot on my neck, and I could see it in every video because it's in high def.
That
and I was like, oh,
so bad.
Kill me.
Exactly.
Like I'm not super vain, but come on. Thing number 2 is something called cognitive search. That's a big word. I mean, not search. It's only like 5 letters.
Right.
But cognitive is a big word. So what exactly is cognitive search?
So cognitive search is the ability for a developer to solve a problem every company has, which is a ton of data that no one knows how to make sense of, all structured and unstructured data.
I feel like that's the definition of like enterprise development is
yeah, exactly.
Every day in and day out, here's a bunch of garbage. Please make sense of this.
Right. Yeah. And now, you know, oftentimes we have to recruit a data scientist or get someone to help us massage. Now we don't need that. Now you can leverage a API, literally a web service, to do text analysis and image analysis, location analysis. Even if you had celebrity data you wanted to analyze, computer vision, you name it, you can now use these services just as checkboxes as it executes an index on your content.
And to add that in, you're just calling an API, right? It's just an endpoint that you call.
Yep.
And you pass it your garbage. And it sends back results? Is that
yes,
how that works?
Exactly.
That sounds awesome.
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, exactly. Caitlin is nothing short of a magician.
So yeah, I'm a big fan.
All right.
Airbrushing is certainly welcome. Especially if you see
I didn't get
lame
it,
shirt.
Yeah. You don't get it either.
That's right. I don't know how you'd airbrush a hair spot.
I know, like a strip of like what happened.
Maybe a sticker.
Or you just close your eyes.
Tattoo overlay.
But look, I got to shave a lot. There's a lot up here that has to be shaved. So, you know, some of it's going to get missed.
That's
a lot
right,
of real estate.
That's right.
Thing number 3 is the custom speech API. Now, I know that the browser already has APIs that can convert speech to text. So where in my application would I plug in the custom speech API?
Yeah, so custom speech is used, there's 2 different pieces of it. One is synthesized voice, so if you want to create a special or fun voice, you could do that. But the other more important one, more functional, is the ability to create a custom language model, which is what's necessary when you try to use a word that isn't understood by the model, right? Or it's like when you talk to Cortana or Alexa and it says, I don't know what you mean by that, right? How do you get around that? Most of the times you're dead in the water, but now you have an opportunity to actually teach it.
You can actually teach it new words.
Yes.
So like I could teach it Elvish.
Yes, you could.
I speak Elvish. Did you know that?
You look like someone who could speak Elvish.
Ouch. Thing number 4 is the custom search API. So how does that work?
Yeah, so you can imagine if you're a developer, we're all familiar with building that search feature. Everybody adds it's like a default function to the page.
The search box on the web page. I hate that so much. I never use the search box on the web page. I don't think anybody uses the search box because you know it's like a guaranteed way to get lost on the site. It might as well just back up and go to the search engine, start all over again.
Exactly. So that's why we created a web service that allows you now to curate your own search and your own search results specifically for your domain so you can control that experience.
So basically you're getting an entire search engine, like a legit search engine, but leveraged for your content and your data.
And you get to control it.
That's pretty nifty.
Yep.
Can you teach it Elvish?
Probably.
Thing number five is the computer vision API. I assume this has something to do with image recognition?
Yeah, image processing. So you can imagine if you have a bot, wouldn't it be great instead of having your users explain everything in text, they could just send you a picture and you could process it.
Nice. So it would be kind of like taking a picture of a receipt because we're in Vegas. We had kind of an expensive dinner last night. Sorry, John. And then it would read the ostentatious bill amount and send that directly to him so he could deny that.
That's right.
Send it back to me. That sounds wonderful.
OCR. Beautiful
thing. Absolutely.
Thing.
Or you could use it to like take a picture of your diary and capture your existential crisis.
That's right. And it could turn it to text. And you could imagine we could even use the speech that we talked about to even create a voice and have it read back to you.
Oh, that's what I need is a computer to read back my diary to me in a voice that's not mine.
It's a little creepy. But anyway.
A little bit terrifying.
I like it. Future.
Free business idea, startup idea, a service that reads your diary back to you in someone else's voice.
That's right.
I think people would love that.
Or Chucky's voice, or whatever.
Oh, gosh.
Or Elmish.
Cool, let's just wrap it up. I'm Bert Collin, and then you're going to say, I'm Noelle LaCharite. I practiced that.
That's beautiful. That's best.
Because I wanted you to like me.
That's awesome. And I do. We're fast friends now.
We're BFFs. I'm Bert Collins.
And I'm Noelle LaCharite.
And now you know five ways that you can infuse AI into your applications today. Did you know I speak Elvish?
You look like someone who could speak Elvish.
You couldn't even get it out.
I'm like, all right,
let's shoot
it
again.
Insulting
you
this
can
man.
Do it. You can do it. You can do it.
All right.